Good evening, basketball fans, and welcome to Hemeter Fieldhouse. It's a loud one here over on campus of Punahou School. This ILH boys basketball showdown between the number one ranked Maryknoll Spartans and your Punahou Buff and Blue. I'm Mike Machado, and joining me tonight, Mr. Alan Ching. How are you, Coach?
I'm doing just great here. Looking forward to a great game between the top two teams in the state.
Well, they are the top two teams in the state, arguably, and first time they met, four-point game. Maryknoll beat them at home. However, and this is a however, Punahou missing the center of their offense, Kuponou Faye.
Yes, Kuponou was a big loss that day. I believe he was ill with some strep throat, but you know, with his big 6'5" body, you know, he's going to be able to give Punahou a lot of help on the boards, which is what they're going to need tonight.
Well, from talking to Coach Robbie Schwab before the game, he knows, like, you know, we think Kupono's worth 4 points a game.
Absolutely, and not only on the offensive end, but he's going to grab a couple rebounds. He's going to alter a few shots, maybe get a couple blocks.
So. And he can potentially bring the ball up to the floor too. We've seen him do that. And Maryknoll, they got some size inside as well, though.
They're very big inside. You know, they all starts out with number 50. You know, Tobias Schramm. You know, averaging just about 10 points a game, and you know he's their bread and butter inside. He's going to affect shots. He's a well polished. Post player with back to the basket moves as well as face up moves.
Right. This place is full, Alan. I don't see it this full unless it's for Holoku pageant or graduation. I think most of Maryknoll school has shown up. I know in the last game it was quite loud, and Maryknoll had a very interesting game with Iolani a couple days ago.
Yeah, a couple days.
That 15-13
final.
Yes.
2-0 at the half.
That's not a quarter score. That was the final. I anticipate a few more points in that today.
Definitely.
And with that, we will go to the starting lineups.
Good afternoon, basketball fans, and welcome to Hemeter Fieldhouse on the campus of Punahou School.
Yeah, it's still loud in here.
It is. It's going to be a fun atmosphere.
This is going to be a great game. This is going to be standing room only, Mr. Ching.
This is what high school basketball is all about. When you got
exactly.
The fan, you got the fans packed, and the energy is really high right now.
Punahou fans are known for not always showing up to games, but when it matters, they show, and it matters, and they're here.
Yeah, we got a packed house. We got a lot of alumni here. From class alumni from the 80s, 90s, and the 2000s all came out of the woodwork.
And I think it's a good case for upping security.
Absolutely.
But we're moments away from tip-off. Jumping for Punahou will be Punahou Faye, and for the Spartans will be Burnett. Faye wins the tip to Danny Andrews. Tanuvasa on the wing to Velasquez for three, and he drains it right away.
That's one thing you cannot do. You cannot let Nick Velasquez set his feet and have a wide open look. He'll kill you all night long.
Velasquez had 28 in the first meeting against the Spartans to lead all scorers, including four threes. And he has the sweetest stroke I've seen in a very long time, Alan.
Yes, he's a pure shooter, but he's really expanding his game a lot this year. But here's one interesting thing Pono's doing on defense. They got kind of out of nowhere, face guarding Gilmore, not even letting him touch the ball. And, you know, with talking with Coach Slav, you know, he said Marino starts and stops with Gilmore.
Right, they caught Jordan Tanuvasa with a reach in there. His first personal foul, first team foul for the Buff and Blue. You see Gilmore off the back of the rim, no good. Andrews with the rebound. Tanuvasa is going to take. Oh, as I say that, he decides to push it up the floor. Finds Pono Fay underneath the basket and in. Buck and Blue out to a quick 5-point lead, just under a minute into play.
Tanuvasa is showing some great, great vision on that one.
See Gilmore pushing it up, finding Harris waiting. Turnabout is fair play. Hiram Harris, originally from New Zealand, a member of their rugby team.
The New Zealand national team. I mean, you look at his body, you can definitely see that.
And you know he's not going to be afraid of contact. Capone Fay trying one from three. That's no good. Rebound by Harris. He's going to try to bring it out. Andrews is harassing him. Dan Barra looking for the ball. He's going to bring it up for the Spartans. Guarded by Tanuvasa. Vladimir Marino's office revolves around getting the ball to Caleb Gilmore and having him distribute. And Burnett's going to be fouled by Velasquez, reaching in.
Yeah, right there, you know, putting those two fouls are all on reach-ins, you know, not really needed. You know, you just want to conserve those fouls for a later time, but.
Buffalo Blue's second team foul with a little over 90 seconds into the game. Coach Kelly Grant for the Spartans, talking to their head referee, Donovan Lewis, wondering, hey, I was. Timeout.
In that situation, I agree with Coach Grant. I mean, it was clear that Burnett was going up with the shot, and that's when Velasquez down on the arm. But, you know, the refs saw it otherwise, and it's only their opinion that counts, not ours.
That's right. They're the ones in the striped shirts. Of course, Punahou jumped out to a quick 5-0 lead on a three-pointer from Velasquez and a layup from Kupono Fay. Marino answered quickly, layup by Hiram Harris. Nick Velasquez leading the ILH in scoring, 16.5 per game.
And he's really rounding out his offensive game by, you know, adding some dribble penetration, floaters, and pull-up jumpers.
You see Burnett pull up Jay, off the back of the iron, no good. Schramm with the rebound. He's going to, a lot of traffic. He's stripped by Tanuvasa. He's got a two-on-one. Kanavainoa trying to dish it quickly to Pono Fay. Noah picks up the loose ball and wisely pulls it down. Pono Fay on the baseline, drives off the glass. No good. Getting the rebound. Nope. They're going to call it off of Pono Fay. Marino ball.
Yeah, Pono missed a, you know, three-point blank layup, but then when you got Schramm affecting your shot, he definitely... You can see why you missed there.
6'9 is going to cast a shadow.
Yeah, a very big one.
6'9 is going to cast a shadow. See, nice defense by Kupono Fay. Velasquez picks up the loose ball. 3-on-3 for Punahou. Velasquez going to drive in traffic, up off the front of the rim, no good. Rebound by Burnett. They're going the other way, 2-on-1. Tanuvasa draws the foul. That's going to be 2 on Tanuvasa. We're going to see Dayson Watanabe, I assume, and yes, we are. Dayson Watanabe quickly off the bench. Tanuvasa's got two quick personal fouls.
Yeah, that's tough for Punahou. You know, Tanuvasa is an experienced point guard, but the good thing about this is that he was hurt at near the beginning of the year, and Dayson got a lot of quality playing minutes in the preseason.
And they platoon anyway. I mean, between the first team and the second teams for Punahou, I mean, they, you know, coach says, well, we have no first team. Yeah, okay, you have your guy, your first five that start, then the next five that come in at 3.5 minutes. Yeah. And Watanabe is perfectly capable, has proven himself capable.
He's proven that he can handle the ball under pressure, he can knock down big shots, and he's a very, very adequate 1B, I guess you could say.
Right. You see Burnett drains the second free throw to bring it to 5-4. Quinnahoe with the lead at 5:29 remaining in the first quarter. See, the Spartans are going to sit Burnett. Watanabe bringing the ball up. He wants to drive, dishes it back to Velasquez. Being marked by Ogata. Looking down low to Fay. He's going to pull it out. Turning on Harris. Left hand off the glass and in. Cupono Fay. Nice footwork.
Very nice footwork. Nice spin dribble on the baseline. And a nice left hand finish. Great job.
They're going to find Harris under the basket. Straight up Cupono Fay. There's Harris again. If Marino's bigs can manage to stay out of foul trouble, they could give this Quinnahoe team some real difficulty.
Yes, Harris is definitely a force underneath the basket.
See Gilmore going back the other way. Watanabe trying to draw the charge. They're going to let it go. Gilmore off the glass. Marino out to their first lead of the game by a score of 8-7.
This is Marino can score in bunches right here, and they scored the 4 points in about 30 seconds right there.
See, Kanavainoa is going to get fouled from behind by Dan Barra.
And right there, Marino went to their 2-3 matchup zone, and you know they're very comfortable playing that zone. They tried man a couple times, left Velasquez open, but now they're going to go back to their zone.
Watanabe inbounding the ball to Velasquez.
And they're going back to their man-to-man here. Let's see what Puerto can do against this.
Kanavainoa back to Watanabe. Watanabe looking for the screen. Think about point up. He's driving behind the back pass. Maybe a little too fancy.
Yeah, but you know he did the right thing. He penetrated the gap, did a great head and shoulder fake, took it to the hole strong, and drew the foul off of Harris.
That'll be Harris's first foul, second team foul for the Spartans.
Marino matches up man-to-man out of bounds. It seems like they're switching all the guard-to-guard exchanges or switches.
Watanabe driving left hand, dishing to Fay. He's blocked by Harrison Schramm. All of a sudden, the forest just collapsed around Cupono Fay. I think Watanabe probably could have taken that one himself.
Yeah, it was a very tough pass and tough position to put Fay in there.
So Kanavainoa getting a marking assignment on Caleb Gilmore. Harris turning, bodied up by Fay. Harris turns underneath. Great move by Hiram Harris on Cupono Fay.
That was some great footwork by Harris. He had a little pump fake, stutter step, and finished his layup. It was a great shot by Harris.
Reno out to a three-point lead. Noah with the three. No good. Air ball. Schramm with the rebound. Looking for Dan Barra.
Yeah, it's a little ill-advised quick shot there by Noah, but you know, hopefully Puno can just bear down here on defense.
See Watanabe marking up on Dan Barra. Top of Harris Fay, kind of giving him a little bit of room. Gets his hand on the pass, picked up by Noah. Great defense by Cupono Fay. Coach Darren Masuda is going to call a 30-second timeout to talk things over. He wants to make sure he gets a basket on this next possession.
Yeah, right now, you know, Puno's a little struggling with their offense a little bit. They got to decide what they want to do. They're attacking a little bit too deep, you know. Maybe what we got to have Dason pull up for a short jumper in the key or look for kickouts for Velasquez.
His last two trips down the floor, we've seen Watanabe make good penetration, only to find, you know, behind the back pass or a tough pass to Puno Fay, only to be, you know, he's quickly closed on.
Yes, he's getting a little bit too deep, and once when you're 5, you know, 10, and you're going in there with 6'4", 6'9".
Generously.
What? You know, he's going to get caught in there, and it cuts down your passing angles, cuts down your shooting angles. He just needs to stop right around the 10-foot mark and look for his pull-up jumper.
You see, and we're normally well past the time Coach Darren Matsuda for the Buff and Blue will put in his B team. Andrews, short jumper, off the back iron, no good. Fay getting battling for the rebound. Tyson Koloa recently checked in for the Spartans, collects the rebound. Gilmore, closely marked by Noah Gilmore. Off the glass, right hand, no good. Andrews with the rebound. Gilmore's getting all kinds of penetration on Quinnahoe.
Yes, he is. You know, you can't take risks off Gilmore. You can't reach up high because then he's going to go blow right by you.
See Andrews. See, Watanabe being marked up by Gilmore. Looking again for the quick pass to Andrews, and he's blocked from behind by Gilmore. He's in a forest right there. He's having the ball. Loose ball. Watanabe picks it up. Burnett chasing him. Watanabe for three. Off the front iron, no good. Rebound by Faith. Put back. Off the back iron, no good. Rebound by Burnett. Fast break. He's got a one-on-two. Kupono Faye playing some very stout defense.
He's playing some great defense, and he's not picking up his fouls. He's being active but being smart about his hands. That's the fourth turnover they've created off of Mariner, and that's going to be...
And at least two of them have been a result of Kupono Faye's defense.
Absolutely. His hands have been very active.
Nick Velasquez, long three. Front iron, no good. Rebound by Gilmore. They're going to slow it down. Just under a minute and a half remaining in the first period. Marinol out to a 10-7 lead after Punahou jumped out to a 5-0 start. So Spartans on a 10-3 run. A long three-pointer off the front iron, no good. Rebound by Faye. He's going to bring the ball up the floor. He's got Velasquez, one on none. That's going to be a not so easy layup for Velasquez. He's fouled by Burnett.
Yeah, right there, Burnett, you know, was pacing him off, going to go for the big, spectacular block. Velasquez did the right thing. Jumped up, jumped into him, drew the contact. Now he can go to the line.
Notice he went to the other side on the layup, yeah. Using the rim as the defense.
Yeah, he shielded him off with the rim and had a nice little scoop shot on the backside. And this is exactly what Punahou needs now. They're getting a little sloppy, rushing some shots. Now they get to the line. It's going to be a nice, hopefully.
Velasquez misses the first one.
He's going to need to hit this one because they need to get off that number seven. They've been stuck on seven for a while.
And here you see a number of subs for both teams.
And with all these subs coming in from Marino, right now our coach Darren's going to have to, you know, look to maybe put some full court pressure up, maybe some half court traps, see how the second team can do for Marino.
Velasquez drains the second, and he's subbed in for Randon Oda. Velasquez is going to sit for the remainder of this first period. Marinol up by a score of 10-8, 1:06 remaining in the first quarter. Heard a packed Hemeter Fieldhouse. I'm Mike Machado. Coach Alan Ching enjoying what's looking like a good one.
Right,
pressure
there.
Defense paying off. Oda to JB Cam. He's thinking about going over Schramm. Schramm stays straight up. Faye with the rebound. Back out to Cam for three. Front iron, no good. Rebounded by Marinol.
But right there,
Tamamoko Green with the rebound.
Yeah, Punahou went to their full court press, created a nice turnover, but they took a couple quick shots there.
You see Green back outside to Koloa. Closely guarded by JB Cam, and Cam gets the strip. They're gonna call Koloa had possession and a timeout.
Wow.
30-second timeout, so that's two timeouts they've had to burn here in the first quarter.
Yeah, you know, and that's going to prove pivotal in the end of the game. They've only got three left for the rest of the game, and they got three quarters. I don't like that. When I was coaching, we used to tell the players, you are not allowed to call a timeout unless it's the fourth quarter, because that possession is really irrelevant for them right now.
In a two-point game in the first quarter? Situational.
Yeah, situational. You don't need to use that timeout. That timeout's more valuable in the fourth quarter, and that possession is more important in the fourth quarter.
If it's a two-point game with 30 seconds left in the fourth quarter, take the timeout.
Yeah.
Take the timeout.
Yeah, exactly. But now, you know what? If there's a scrum like that in the fourth quarter, they may be out of it. And so, you know, it's just one of those things. But, you know, you got to like that. The Marinol team, you know, he's thinking about it. And he's trying to make the right play, but...
Under normal circumstances, you'd call it a heady play, but it's maybe a little more situational. These are kids.
Yep.
These are high school kids.
This is high school basketball.
There you see Dan Barra. Watanabe giving him some room. Like they're waiting for one.
Yeah, they brought back in their stars, and they're milking for one shot here.
Dan Barra drives up and under, off the glass and in. 4 seconds remaining. Micah Ma'a pushing the ball up the floor. Watanabe gets a shot off, and that will be well short. Marinol with a late basket in the first quarter takes a 12-8 lead to finish the first quarter. Mr. Ching, we got a good one here.
Yes, we do. You know, you've seen the energy. You've seen a lot of nervous jitters with some plays that they, you know, we don't normally see out of both sides, but with, you know, the big big time, big game atmosphere that we got right here. Jitters are going to be a part of it, but, you know, after the first 8 minutes of great basketball, everything should be settled down. We should be able to see some really good, another good 24 minutes.
Well, Jordan Tanuvasa picked up two quick fouls early going, and he had to sub out for Dason Watanabe. And there you see Coach Darren giving instruction to some of his bigs, Danny Andrews and J.B. Cam. J.B. Cam, one of many sophomores, many sophomores on this Buff and Blue team.
And that's what people don't really realize. This is a very young team for the Buff and Blue. With only four seniors on the squad, this team will be staying intact for the next 2 to 3 years, and it's going to be very interesting to see how these guys grow up together.
And the second quarter is underway. Gilmore, 23 on 23. Velasquez guarding Gilmore. Ball stripped by Velasquez. Loose ball picked up by Cam. Dishes to Tanuvasa. Is he going to take his time? Thought about pushing it. Tanuvasa being marked by Gilmore. Switches off on Schramm. Tanuvasa turns the corner off the glass and in.
It's a great pick and roll, high pick and roll by Andrews, and Tanuvasa just took it right in, had a nice little floater from six.
Right around Toby Schramm. Of course, Mary Knoll has four of the top 10 scorers in the ILH. Caleb Gilmore's third, averaging.
That was a big block there by Andrews. And he just
showing off some of those fast twitch volleyball muscles.
Definitely.
You see, checking back into the game for the Spartans, number 25, Josh Burnett, replacing Atamamoko Green. See, Schramm turns, and they're going to count the basket. They're going to call Andrews on with the foul.
Right there, just Andrews got muscled out right there on the low block. You know, he's giving up probably like 40 to 50 pounds, and Schramm just used a simple drop step and took Schramm to the hole.
You know, and Toby Schramm made some noise last year. Everybody knew who he was. But he came back this year a much different player.
Yes, definitely. He dropped a lot of weight in the offseason, worked at it, and he's just improved his game greatly.
You see Andrews for three. That's going to draw iron, no good. And who are they going to call this foul on? They're going to call Nick Velasquez pushing off. Velasquez with his second and Buff and Blue's 15th foul. That'll be interesting to see if Coach Matsuda pulls Velasquez.
Right now it seems like he's going to trust his senior that he can play without fouling, but he's guarding the best down Marinol, so we'll see.
Nice turn by Gilmore in the lane, off the glass and in. Marinol out to a 6-point lead.
That is just a tough move. I mean, Velasquez was able to move his feet, cut him off on his first move, but that second spin move got him.
Tanuvasa into the lane, kicks out to Andrews, thinks about the short J. Andrews off the glass and in from about 6 feet.
That's what Pinho really needs to do now. They need to take the ball into the hole. But the thing is that they're selling for 3-point shots.
Nice fake by Hiram Harris. Drawing the Pinho defense up.
He's showing a lot of good body control by making that nice jump stop, pump fake, and he goes.
Tanuvasa for two. Schramm with the rebound. Trying a quick outlet, Velasquez chasing it down. Back into Tanuvasa. Nice hustle by Nick Velasquez getting back as Burnett was also giving chase for Marinol.
Yeah, that was just an ill-advised pass there by Harris. You know, he thought his man was leaking out, but he just can't give up the turnovers like that.
Well, you see Ma'a looking down low for Andrews. They'll call it off of Harris. You put a whole ball and checking back into the game for the Buff and Blue are Kanavainoa and Kupono Faye. So all five of Punho's starters on the floor.
You know, Coach Masuda is making a strategic, you know, change in his usual game plan. Not platooning, but he's still getting all, you know, his top 10 players in the game.
Marino also with their starting five on the floor. Tanuvasa turning on Dan Barra. Off the glass, no good. Rebound by Faye, putback, no good. Tip by Schramm, Tanuvasa with the rebound. He's blocked by Schramm with the putback. Looking for Harris on the fast break. Nice outlet pass by Hiram Harris. Marino out to an 8-point lead. And Punahou's going to take a timeout, and they need it. Maryknoll crowd going nuts.
The Maryknoll fans, they came to support their Spartans, and you know they're giving them a great show. Harris is just showing a lot of good agility, really nice soft feet. He's playing a hell of a game.
Maryknoll out to a 20-12 lead on the Buffalo Blue. Of course, Buffalo Blue started fast on that 5 points in the first 52 seconds. And since then, it's a 20-7 run for the Spartans.
It seems that, you know, Punahou's just buying into this fast-paced game. You know, they're taking quick three-pointers. They're penetrating kick-out shots. They need to make Maryknoll work on defense. See if they can play 30 seconds of defense, a good defense. But, you know, right now, we'll see what kind of adjustments Coach Masuda makes.
We shall see. A lot of the games this year have not been close. So, I mean, that's the thing. In games where you're playing a lot of blowouts, you don't have to coach a close game. So especially if you're not used to playing from behind, as Punahou isn't, more often than not.
You know, this is one of the few games that they've been really pushed. They have, you know, Maryknoll has some excellent size, and they have some excellent guards. And so this is a great matchup for Punahou, and we're going to see how well they can adjust to being down here.
Tanavasa being guarded by Dan Barra. Andrews, Velasquez, closely marked by Burnett. Trying to draw Burnett out for a pick and roll. Velasquez pulls back out up top to Fay. Harris giving him a lot of room. Back out to Velasquez, driving baseline to Fay, off the glass and in. Cupono Fay, a much needed basket for the Buff and Blue.
That was, you know, your two seniors taking over there. Velasquez with a nice baseline drive, gets it to Fay, who I thought got a little body contact there, but he still finishes layup.
Still a lot of time left in this game. We're almost halfway here in the second quarter. Burnett with a long three, hits iron, no good, loose ball. Cupono Fay brings it out. Showing off some handle, he's got a 3-on-2, Andrews and Velasquez. Andrews takes it in himself. Punahou closes the lead to 4. And of course, Maryknoll's already burned their 2 30s. Under this circumstances, you might see him call a 30, but I don't think Coach Grant wants to burn his third time out in the first half. Gilmore in the traffic, blocked by Kanavainoa.
Kanavainoa got beat on the dribble, but didn't give up on the play, came back strong with an excellent block.
Of course, Kanavainoa, an outstanding football player for the Buff and Blue. And on many other teams, he'd be the focus of some offenses, but on this team, he's the intangible guy. He's the hustle guy. He's marking Maryknoll's best player in Caleb Gilmore.
He's the gritty-gutty guy that does everything that doesn't show up in the stats. He's on the floor, he's playing great defense, and he's getting a lot of tips.
And he's arguably the best athlete on the floor.
Absolutely, yeah. You see him on the football field, it's just amazing.
To Burnett. Andrews comes out to meet him. Burnett trying to get the ball through traffic. They're calling him with a charge.
And there he is again.
And that's going to be 2 on Joshua Burnett. 4th team foul for the Spartans.
And there is, you know, Kanavainoa doing all the things that doesn't show up. He stepped in, took a charge right in the chest. And, you know, now Punahou can maybe go on a nice, you know, 6-7 point run right here. Cut it down to 2.
Here, Noah, closely guarded by Gilmore. Pono Fay thinking about the J, drives, dishes out to Andrews. He might have had the shot there. Velasquez traveled, thought about the 3.
Yeah.
Thought about it a little too long, shuffle the feet.
That's what happens when he just gets a little bit too, you know, indecisive. I thought Nick, you know, knowing Nick, he would just, you know,
if he had
up
pumped it first time, I think he might have had it.
Yep. That's only the second turnover by the Buff and Blue, compared to 7 for the Spartans.
Burnett looking down low to Schramm, double teamed by Andrews. Andrews, they're going to call. Andrews is thinking he got all ball, and he's not happy about that.
Yeah, that seemed to be, you know, I tend to agree there with Andrews on that one. He seemed to get a lot of the ball. Maybe the ref saw some body contact, but, you know, if you're looking at both sides of the court, there's a lot of body contact on both sides. I think maybe that's when they can let the players play.
Okay, here's Schramm at the line, shooting 2. Of course, now that rattles in and out. Of course, Punahou now with 16 fouls, 2 each on Tanuvasa, Andrews, and Velasquez.
Yeah, there's a little athletic justice there. You know, the ball, you know, the saying goes, the ball never lies.
And the second one, nothing but net for Toby Schramm. Spartans out to a 5-point lead, 21-16, 2:53 remaining in the first half here at Hemeter Fieldhouse. Navasa closely marked by Gilmore. Top to Velasquez. Andrews checking out. Velasquez left-handed drive, dish out to Fay. Nola thinking about it, back to Tanuvasa. In traffic, up, hits the front of the rim, no good. Rebound, collected by Danbara. Who are they gonna call that one on? Could be on.
I think that's gonna be on Nola.
Yes.
Will be on Konovai Nola. That'll be his first and the seventh team foul for the Buff and Blue.
And right here, Coach Masuda is going with it. There's two point guards in the game together at the same time, you know. They can match up really good with Marino, with Danbara, and Gilmore, so this will be an interesting matchup with the guards.
And of course, Coach Kelly Grant for the Spartans counters by subbing in Sean Ogata, 5'9" junior guard, for the Spartans to match the smallness that the Buffalo put in the backcourt.
But here's the thing, one of those guys are going to have to either guard Nick Velasquez, so we'll see if they can push Nick to the post, maybe get him some back-to-basket
moves. They have
the
5'9 Ogata on the 6'2 Velasquez. Tanuvasa out on the wing for Watanabe for a three, and he drains it. Dason Watanabe cuts to a three-point lead for the Spartans.
I mean, right now, Puno's getting everything off their penetrating pitch. They're seeing high pick and rolls, or they're just bringing their man off the dribble, and they're looking to spot up for their shooters. And Watanabe just buried that one.
See Schramm. Looking for Gilmore, tightly marked by Watanabe. Gilmore for three, no good. Back of the iron. Harris with the rebound, back out to Ogata. Double teamed in the corner by Fay, inside to Harris. That's going to be an easy, and they're going to call for a travel. Harris, one too many pump fakes for Hiram Harris.
Too many pump fakes. He got a little happy with his feet. You know, he got a first good one, let the man go by, but then he shuffled those feet after that. It was a good call by the refs.
Coach Kelly Grant trying to talk to the official. There's Jordan Tanuvasa, long three, and Quinaho ties it up, 22-22. What was once an 8-point lead for the Spartans at 20-12. And Buff and Blue on a 10-2 run.
And we're going back to it again. They burned those two 30-second timeouts early, and now, you know, they can't use it.
Hiram Harris causing all kinds of problems for the Buff and Blue down low.
You know, what's happening is that the guards, it's really the guards that are getting beat, and so the posts are having to help off of Harris, which leaves them wide open.
Watanabe for another three, and he drains it. Buff and Blue out to a 25-24 lead with 50 seconds remaining in the first half.
Three three-pointers in a row by the two guards. Great substitution by Coach Masuda. You know, it's paying off dividends now.
Trying to get the Puno shooter some looks. Danbara drives, no good. Rebound by Harris. Kicks out to Gilmore for three. Off the back of the iron, no good. Rebound by Fay. He's trying to get out. Has Velasquez on the break. Gilmore trailing. Velasquez, no good. Rebound by Watanabe. 23 seconds remaining. Watanabe is going to call a 30, I believe. Yes. Coach Robbie Shklov asking our score if we got a 30. Now both teams have burned both their 30s. So going into the second half, assuming no more timeouts are called, each team will have three full timeouts.
And you know, with that timeout there, it got trapped in the corner. He gives Coach Masuda a way to set up, you know, a last second shot. You know, you can go up. You'll be up one, maybe three, maybe 4 points. I mean, right there, Marino just had some, you know, just breakdowns on their defense, just leaving shooters open. And, you know, it's the same thing. The Puno guards are beating their defender to the hole, and they're kicking out for wide open threes.
And of course, on that last sequence there, you'd like to see Punahou doing well on those fast breakup. There's a number of them there that they haven't done as well as they could have in finishing.
Yeah, and that's the whole thing. If you're going to run, we need to finish.
So Punahou's going to hold for the final shot with 15 seconds remaining in the first half from Hemeter Fieldhouse. Buffalo blew up by a score of 25-24 over their neighbors from across Wilder Avenue, the Maryknoll Spartans. 5 seconds. Anyone know what's on the clock? Anyone talking to him? Velasquez thinking about three. Velasquez trying to find some room. And that's going to be the half. Interesting sequence there. I didn't see, I think Velasquez got a little bottled up and he was surprised and not getting a shot off and nobody was telling him how much time was left.
Yeah, he just got lost a little track of time there and just got the ball taken from him. Yeah, they got a little discombobulated on their offense.
But that's the half. Buffen blew up by a score of 25-24. And for your halftime entertainment, we will have the Punahou cheerleaders and the Punahou dance team. So we'll be right back with the second half.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Hemeter Fieldhouse on the campus of Punahou School. We're at halftime between the Mary Knoll Spartans and the Punahou Buff and Blue, number one and number two teams in the state, Alan Ching, in a very exciting first half of basketball.
Yeah, you don't expect anything less when you have the two top teams in the state. It's a one-point game, and both teams have shown their runs, their little spurts. You know, Mary Knoll had got out to, I believe, like a 6 to 8 point.
8 point, right? They were up 20 to 12.
20 to 12, and then Polo comes back with three straight three-pointers by Watanabe and Tanuvasa, and, you know, they take the halftime lead up by one.
I think having Mary Knoll be good at basketball is good for basketball in Hawaii. Yeah. Because when they're good, the rivalry between them and Punahou just becomes that much more intense.
Oh yeah, I mean, like, it's great to see other teams besides Kamehameha, Iolani, and Punahou, you know, competing with each other. You know, Mary Knoll is, if you know the history, it has a great basketball history with Tony Salido when he was a coach there. You know, there's no, you know, without a gym and everything else, and, you know, they won state championships and competed for state championships. It's a great basketball school. And just, yeah, you're right. It just makes the rivalry just down the road even better.
Literally across the street from each other. Can't get any closer.
Yep.
We're back to action. Jordan Tanuvasa. Kupono Faye, spot up three. No good. Harris with the rebound. Dan Barra taking his time. Walking it up for the Spartans. Schramm up high. Harris. In the key, left-handed right around Kupono Faye. Hiram Harris with his 14th point of the game, Alan.
He's just being a dominant force on the inside. Right there, they ran a down pick for him. He just ran a curl over the top and had a nice, nifty left-handed shot.
Right around Kupono Faye. At some point, Kupono Faye is going to start dishing out his fouls, I think.
Yeah, right now, I mean, it's...
He may need to.
It was one of those things, you know, he played very smart in the first half. Didn't pick up a foul, but now, you know, he's at five in 16 minutes. So he might as well, you know, contest some of those shots a little bit more aggressively.
Maybe put a body on some of them.
Put a body on, you know, not make it so easy for him to just to maneuver down there. Yeah, bump the cutters, not make it as easy to get from point A to point B.
We saw Harris out to Dan Barra, trying to find Schramm. Being fronted by Andrews back inside, looking for Schramm. Dan Barra was driving baseline. He lost it. Fast break to Kupono Faye with the layup and in. Kupono Faye. Nice hustle by the big man.
Yes, great lead pass out there, and he caught it in stride and finished strong at the rim. And right there, Burnett, you know, usually would contest that, but with two fouls, he could not afford to pick up his third.
Burnett with the pick. Dan Barra for three. Back iron, no good. Noah with the rebound. Tanuvasa pushing it up. Buff and Blue with a one-point lead. Teams have traded baskets here in the early 2 minutes into the third period. Tanuvasa pulls up from 15. Back iron, no good. Faye tries to tip in. That's also no good. Rebound collected by Harris. Hiram Harris is he's impressing me.
He's a force inside.
He's impressing me.
He has nice feet, nice hands, and nice. He knows how to his way around the basket.
This is Gilmore, long three, drawing a lot of air.
He just was a little bit too excited for that shot, you know, kind of forced it. Needs to let the offense come to him. And that's one of the good things about this crowd. They didn't start chanting air ball because you don't want to get mad.
Yeah. It's not this crowd's style, really.
Yeah.
See Velasquez guarded by Burnett. Turns, goes baseline, right-hand floater, no good. Rebounded by Harris.
Who else? It's going to be Harris underneath both baskets. He'll be around there. He's really impressive tonight.
Gilmore, Burnett running around the screen. Tracked by Velasquez. Switches courts to Gilmore. And guarded by Noah. Looking inside to Schramm. Kupono Faye backs off. Schramm misses the wide-open shot from underneath.
Yeah,
he needs to hit that.
He needs to hit that. Those are those shots that just kill you. I mean, right there is very important 2 points.
And Puno was just going straight up. Tanuvasa trying to go off the glass, no good. Dan Barra with the rebound. He'd be wise to pull this up. He does not have numbers. Dan Barra being chased by Tanuvasa.
Quinnell's playing some really good man-to-man defense right now. The last few trips down the court, they're really helping each other well and rotating to the ball.
Dan Andrews, great job of sticking his hand in on the entry pass to Toby Schramm.
Yeah, that's a 10th turnover Quinnell has created, you know.
Andrews for three. Did he get fouled on that? Velasquez with the rebound and back in for Nick Velasquez off the missed three.
Yeah, right there. Andrews can hit those three-pointers, but it was a little too quick in the offense, but credit Velasquez for never giving up, following that miss and putting it in.
Velasquez averaging 16.5 points per game in ILH play.
He's been pretty quiet other than that last basket and the three-pointer hit to open the game. You guys see him get...
There you see Danbara gets stripped by Velasquez, and then the loose ball. Danbara spots up for three. No good, off the back iron. Schramm with the rebound. He turns, runs into Andrews, and he's going to get the and one. Dan Andrews doesn't know what happened.
Yeah, right there, you know, it's just a matter of size. Andrews just needs to go straight up rather than, you know, bringing his hand down, trying for that block.
We see some substitutions. Jason Watanabe and J.D. Cam checking into the game for Danny Andrews and Connor Vainoa.
That's three on Andrews.
Andrews just doesn't have the girth.
No.
To match with Toby Schramm. He's got the length. Even though he gives up a couple 3 inches in height, he's got the wingspan to reach in and do it.
Yeah, but he's just
Velasquez, quick three. Excuse me, front iron, no good. Rebound by Fay. He marked by Harris, trying to go baseline, hoping for the foul. Throws it back up top to Watanabe. Watanabe driving in traffic. He gets blocked from behind by Danbara. J.D. Cam cross court to Watanabe. He's blocked. Marion Old fans going nuts. Velasquez with the steal. Gilmore and Burnett chasing. Velasquez, no good. And they're going to call Burnett with a foul. I think that's going to be his third.
That's his third foul. And right there, you know, anytime there's a breakaway layup, the referees will call any contact on the person shooting it. And right there, Burnett just got his hand on Velasquez's back. Didn't really push him hard, but you got to think about the safety of the player right there. And, you know, Donovan Lewis, the referee, made a good call.
Velasquez on the line for two. Sinks the first one. As Burnett picking up his third foul, he'll be subbed out for Tomomoko Green, also a New Zealander. Tomomoko Green checking in for the Spartans.
Yeah, then you know they had to take Burnett out there with picking up his third. He's going to be sitting probably to the start of the fourth.
See Velasquez's second free throw rattles in and out. Buffalo Blue to a 2-point lead, 3 minutes remaining in the third period. Number one and number two teams in the state. Green looking down low to Schramm. He's great space between Cam and Fay. Quick inbound pass. Velasquez looking to push. In traffic. Ill-advised shot from Nick Velasquez, I think.
Yeah, right there he was trying to draw the foul, but just didn't have it.
Caleb Gilmore goes back the other way, and he's going to draw the and. They're going to call a charge, I think. Going back the other way, no basket.
See, right there, you know, that's why there is no arc rule. You can take the charge anywhere on the court, even under the basket right there. And that's where Watanabe took that charge. It was under the basket, but in high school, that's a good play. College or the pros, that's a block or a no call.
There's some of the fans not liking the call.
Yep, no, I mean,
you can only assume. Yes.
Yep. But it was the right call. It was the right call.
They count the basket. The scoreboard hasn't changed yet. They gave him the basket on that. You may need to check that.
What the referee may have called was that the ball was released before the contact was made.
So Micah Ma'a showing some hustle. Buffalo Blues setter, also a basketball player. Buffalo Blues volleyball setter, excuse me. That ball's picked off by Harris. He caught that off the face. And a Mary Knowles calling a full timeout to give Hiram Harris some time to recoup. We'll need to see how they have to get somebody to check with that to see if.
Right now, with Coach Masuda, they're going to have to really check on their offense and their defense right now. It's going to be really interesting to see what adjustments they make. You know, right now, Mariners are on the little bit of a mini run. There's been some turnovers and sloppy play. So we're going to have to take a look at, see if Puno can settle down.
It's right.
A clean set.
I should know better than to question our official scorer. Miss Christina.
Oh, yes. She's
good.
Better.
We got lickings after this. We're back to action. 1:49 remaining. We're all 30s here in the third period at Hemeter Fieldhouse. Mary Nolan Punahou, 1-2 in the state. We're going to call J.D. Cam the foul on Harris, reaching. That's Cam's first. Buffalo Blue's second team foul. Looking for Schramm on the inbound inside to Harris. They're going to call a foul before that, I believe. And they're going to call Kupono Fay with his first foul. Third team foul for the Buffalo Blue. Get it into Schramm, being bodied up by Cam. He turns in the key, no good. Rebound by Harris. They're going to call a jump ball. And it will remain Spartans' possession.
You know, I like how Justin Cam just sticks his nose in there, goes after that rebound. You know, he's giving up a lot of size and weight, but, he's a scrapper in there.
One of the many Buff and Blue sophomores on the floor. In fact, we have four of them on the floor right now. The only see Green and misses a long three. Rebound by Dayson Watanabe. Got Randinota on the wing. I said Kupono Fay, the only senior on the floor. Randinota, JB Cam, Micah Mutton, Dayson Watanabe, all sophomores. Watanabe, long three, no good.
Right there, he's just got a little quick. Didn't have his feet set. Took a little ill-advised shot, but like we said, you said he's a sophomore and he's going to learn.
Right. And of course, you heard the air ball chants.
They're starting to get a little feisty in Hemeter Fieldhouse today.
Neighbors across the way, a triple header here today. The D2 boys, Punahou and Maryknoll played earlier. Now we have the D1 game between the Punahou and Maryknoll boys. And following this, we have senior night for the Buff and Blue girls. Between Punahou and Iolani.
And that's going to be another great game, It's always a rivalry game, and it's always fun to be a part of.
And Gilmore pulls up and no good. Quick to Cam, Watanabe pulls up. Randon Oda's going to drive. Floater in the lane, he drains it. Buck and Blue out to a two-point lead, 25 seconds remaining in the third quarter.
That's just a great shot by Oda. I mean, he made it look so easy, but those little six-foot runners are very difficult. Great shot by Oda.
They're going to Kupono Fay talking to Josh Burnett. They're going to call the foul on Micah Ma'a, his first, Buffalo Blue's fourth team foul. He's going to have Burnett at the line. Shooting two. Is that two or three? Yes. As I said that, glad I have so much help. Of course, we don't have a statistician sitting here, but I say things in such close quarters in here.
Yeah, it's one of those things. We got a lot of helpful hands, helpful eyes out here.
Of course, the moment I said that, I realized he was taking a three.
Yep.
And now we see Burnett taking the second of his three shots to even the score potentially.
And then that's one of those, Cardinal rules. You never want to foul a three-point shot shooter. You know, and here's Coach Grant putting in a couple subs, giving his two bigs a little extra rest before the fourth quarter.
And Coach Matsuda countering with some shooters.
Let's see if Puno can execute their last inning shot a little bit better than they did in the end of the first half.
Burnett manages to drain it. We're all tied with 13 seconds remaining in the third period. A very low-scoring third period. Jason Watanabe on the drive, off the glass and in. Nice drive by Jason Watanabe. And Quinho enters the fourth quarter with a two-point lead, 34-32. Great drive by Jason Watanabe.
Jason Watanabe recognized that there was no bigs in the game. They took out Harris, they took out Schramm. So once you get by that, you know, get by your man, it's a free and easy lane to the hole, and he took advantage of that. Great layup, great drive. Good way to finish out the quarter for the Buff and Blue.
This game looking like a much lower scoring game than their first adventure on January 9th across the street. The Spartans were victorious 70-66, as we alluded to before, much higher scoring game. Nick Velasquez went for 28. Burnett went for, Gilmore went for 19.
Right, and right now it's because of their effort on the defensive end. They are putting, both teams are putting a very concerted effort not to give up, you know, easy layups, and they're playing very clean, and it's just one of those games that, you know, sometimes it's the offense, sometimes it's the defense, and right now the defense is winning out. Both squads are playing excellent help side, on ball, and it's going to be a very exciting 8 minutes.
So Buff and Blue only scored 9 points in that quarter. Spartans scored 8. Winner of this game is going to very well be number one in the next poll, I would imagine, next high school poll.
Yes, I think so, and it's just one of those things that, you know, both of these teams, are, you know, barring any big upsets, you know, should be meeting, you know, sometime down the line in hopefully the state tournament as well.
And I'm not familiar with the playoff scenario, how seedings would go for the ILH, but Mary Knoll's already beaten Iolani twice. They have one more remaining with Kamehameha. Nice dish inside to Caprino Fay. Punahou wanting the foul. As I was saying, Punahou still has a games left with Kamehameha and Iolani remaining. And those are both away games.
Yeah, you know, Punahou has a little bit tougher road down the line, but, you know, this league is really balanced this year with the top four teams easily, all of them capable of beating each other on any given day.
And even if this number two ILH team doesn't get that first round bye in the state tournament, not as important, I mean, in basketball as it may be in some sports. Burnett, back of the iron, no good. Schramm with the rebound, off the glass, no good. Tanivasa, long outlet pass to Kupono Fay, off the glass and in. Nice look by Jordan Tanivasa.
Nice outlet pass, Kupono Fay, that's the second run out he's gotten. You know, he's just beating the bigger Maryknoll Spartans down the court. You know, him sprinting down the court, Andrew sprinting down the court, it's making Schramm and Harris use up a lot of energy. And right now, you look at Schramm and Harris, both of them are just, you know, gassed a little bit. They are.
And this is arguably part of the reason Toby Schramm took his conditioning a little more seriously this last offseason, because last year we were talking about that before. You'd see spurts from about good 2 or 3 minutes, and we're starting to see it now as we get into the fourth quarter. He's looking tired.
He's breathing a little heavy, you know, and you can just tell on free throws. You got Schramm and Harris both grabbing their shorts and trying to, you know, get as much air in as they can. You know, we'll see how much gas they got left in the tank with 7 minutes to play.
You know, it's important to Coach Grant to keep his bigs in the game, because we saw him call a timeout to give Harris a spell.
Yep. You know,
when he took a ball to the face.
Yeah.
Gilmore inbounds to inside to Schramm, off the glass, no good, rebound by Harris.
Right there, Harris is always on the ball.
A 2-point margin.
Harris just has a nose for the ball. He's always around it, offensive boards, defensive boards. He's having a heck of a game.
Velasquez trying to work the pick and roll with Andrews. Back to Tanivasa. He's driving, kicks out to Andrews, thinks about the three. Pulls up off the glass, no good. Rebound by Harris. Hiram Harris having a great game for the Spartans.
Yes, he is. He is. He's just, hopefully for the Spartans, you know, he'll be able to finish the game off.
just over 6 minutes remaining. Buff and Blue with a two-point lead, 36-34. Dan Barra from a three, straight away, back iron, no good. Rebound by Harris. They're going to call a jump ball on that. That would be Marino ball.
Kind of an ill-advised shot there by Dan Barra. I mean, the bigs have been working real well inside. You got to give them touches. You know, they should touch the ball every possession from here on out.
Gilmore, long three, and he drains it. Marino out to a one-point lead.
That was the first open look that they gave Gilmore. You know, it's been Tom Vinoa, it's been Velasquez, all over him, but that's the first good look that they got, and he made them pay for it.
And you know, Nick Velasquez watching this, he wants to get his shot off now.
Yeah.
See, Burnett giving him some space. Velasquez hits front iron. Fay with the rebound, dishes to Andrews. No good, rebound by Schramm. Pinot could have really used a basket on that possession.
Yeah, right there, you know, Andrews went with his right hand. He'd be better off because Schramm was on his inside. Going up with his left hand and low left hand hook shot would have been a better choice for him.
Gilmore being guarded by Watanabe. Gilmore for another three. Draws iron, no good. Rebound by Fay. He's going to bring the ball up. Buff and Blue, three on two. Velasquez up and under, and that's in.
And right there.
Nice outlet pass by Pono Fay.
Pono is going to have to push the ball in transition. Schramm is barely making it past half court, and Harris didn't even make it past half court that time.
Now Coach Grant burns his fourth timeout with just under 5 minutes remaining. Be interesting to see how this plays out because I think he's looking at his bigs gassing right now.
Yes, he is.
They are gassed.
We got about 5 minutes to play. 5 minutes to play in this game with only one timeout. And this is a very big concern, is conditioning. Because Harris did not make it past half court on that last transition play. He is absolutely gassed, but he's giving all he got on the offensive boards, defensive boards. But, you know, it's just going to be imperative for Andrews and Faye to keep on running the court, running the court, running the court.
Of course, you know, Kelly Grant is not new to the game. He won the state title coaching the Kaimuki boys in 2007. So he's not new to this.
No, he's not going to get rattled by being down 1 point with 5 minutes to go. He knows there's a lot of talent. He's a very experienced coach, very good coach. And that can win, has proven that he can win the big games. And so we look to see him make it maybe go to a zone here on defense, maybe mix up his offenses, maybe run some clock on offense to give his bigs a little break during the course of a game.
Buff and Blue up by one, 38-37, just under 5 minutes remaining here at Hemeter Fieldhouse. A packed Hemeter Fieldhouse. Toby Schramm underneath. Nice move by Toby Schramm to use the rim as a block.
Yeah, he caught it on the right side. Notice that Andrews was right there for the block. He just went to his left and went on a reverse layup there. Very, very savvy move there.
Another lead change. Kanavainoa with the ball. Left-handed drive in traffic, looking down low to Pono Fay. He's blocked by Schramm. They're going to call a foul on Toby Schramm, and he's biting his tongue, perhaps, as well.
Right there, Schramm's not saying a word. Coach Grant's not saying a word. Schramm got a lot of the ball, but he did get him very solidly with his body. And that's only his first foul there, so, you know, it's not a bad foul at all.
And you see Capone Fay missing his first of two. Of course, we invite all of you to stick around for the final game of our triple headers. The Buff and Blue girls take on the Iolani Red Raiders. Senior night, see Fay training his second, and we will have Shelly Fay and coaches Shelly Fay and Alan Wong, both state championship winning coaches, in their own rights, calling our girls game following the conclusion of this stunner. Nice D by Kanavainoa.
Right now, Puno needs to push the ball in transition. Maybe set some high picks, you know, utilizing the big men, making those Marino bigs guard 30 feet from the basket.
Fay driving baseline, trying to go up and under. Schramm gets the ball off of Fay, and it will be Spartans with the inbound.
That's Schramm's fourth block of the game, and he's just been a force, you know, affecting a lot of the shots.
And when they discuss that again, Jonathan Lewis says, I saw something else.
Yep. Wait,
no.
Yeah, they reversed the call. Donovan got a little help from the outside referee, and they decided that, yeah, it was off of Marino Spartan.
Coach Grant not real happy about that. All tied at 39s. Packed Hemeter Fieldhouse. I'm Mike Machado. Joining me, Coach Alan Ching. Tanuvasa, double dribble. He saw Harris's big shadow coming at him, and hey!
Yep, he just got a little antsy. You know, you see a big 6'9 guy coming at you, coming to block your shot. It just may make you double dribble. Very important possession here for the Spartans. They should probably go to something, you know, to their bigs, to Harris.
See Burnett pulling up for two, long two. Wow. He drains it.
He shot that with confidence, you know. Rose up, shot with confidence, knocked it down. Very impressive shot.
Spartans out to a 2-point lead. Velasquez looking to run through some picks. Tanuvasa in traffic outside to Capone Fay. Left-handed drive, floater in traffic, and he gets it.
Beautiful move there. That shows the beauty of Capone Fay with his lift fake, left-hand dribble to the middle, and a little left-hand hook to finish it off.
Capone Fay's got some handle.
He's got a lot of handles.
He's an athlete. He's going to play volleyball next year for the University of Hawaii.
And, you know, that's the, you know, Mario has the girth on the inside. Punoa has the active athletic bigs. And it's just a, you know, game of cat and mouse.
See Burnett trying another long three. Tanuvasa with the rebound. Just over 2 minutes remaining. We're all tied. Andrews off the glass and in.
Right there
nice
again.
Nice finish by Danny Andrews.
Yeah, Danny Andrews on the left side. Capone Fay on the right side. And where was Harris? Barely crossed half court. They just need to push the ball in transition and get it to their bigs.
Trying to run Gilmore through some picks. Tanuvasa Noah tightly guarding Caleb Gilmore. Dan Barra, Schramm, looking inside to Harris. Schramm, ill-advised back pass. Velasquez one-on-one. They're gonna say he stepped out of bounds.
Wow.
Tough luck for Nick Velasquez. Letting Kobe Schramm off the hook. Ill-advised back pass. I don't know what he was doing.
I did not know, understand that pass at all either. Maybe he was saw something we didn't from his position, but in any case, a bearing the back pass in traffic is never good.
And this is an ILH game, not an and one tournament.
Yes, that is definitely true as well.
Buffen blew up by two, 1:35 remaining in the contest. Gilmore pulls up for a long three from straightaway. Front iron, no good. Harris with the rebound. He loses it out of bounds. It'll be Punahou ball. 1:26 remaining for the Buffalo Blue. They're up by two.
This is going to turn. This gym is electric. You got a lot of noise on both sides. This is a great atmosphere for high school basketball.
This is what it should be.
Yes.
This is how high school basketball should be. Punahou fans are notorious. I won't say fair weather. They show up when it counts. But, and this game counts. It's number one Marino, number two Punahou. See, both coaches, as I like to say, getting coachy, playing the substitution game.
Wow, look at this. You know, Coach Grant takes out Schramm and Harris. Wow, Schramm and Harris coming out with a minute 26 left. This is going to be a very interesting position.
Remember what happened last time they did this at the end of the half?
Yeah, Deason Watanabe
they
got all the way
straight
to the
hole. And I imagine Tanuvasa is thinking the same thing.
High pick and rolls right here for Punahou coming up.
And Punahou is more than willing to run clock on this. They're
exactly.
Up by two. With 68 seconds remaining in the contest, Tanuvasa being closely guarded by Ogata and Velasquez.
And right now, Marino only has three team fouls. They need to start fouling now.
Ambitious by Nick Velasquez, trying to go floater off the glass. 50 seconds remaining in the contest. Coach Grant calls his final timeout. Buffalo Blue up by two in an electric Hemeter Fieldhouse.
Yeah, it's a very great atmosphere, but right there, Velasquez, kind of, you know, an ill-advised shot. You know, you don't like the senior taking charge of it, thinking that, you know, I'm gonna be the guy that's gonna take that shot. But right there, you can run clock. You can run a lot of clock off. There's no bigs in there. You can get a better shot than that.
I think he thought he had a little more room when he initiated his dribble, and then he had to drift a little farther out. And then, as you saw, the shot ended up a little short off the glass.
Yeah, it is. So, you know, but right now, if the last is with Coach Masuda, you got to move past it. And he has to have your best defensive right now. You know Mariners are going to run some sort of high pick and roll with them, with Gilmore throwing to the basket or somebody with Schramm or Harris down there. So, you got to play your solid man-to-man defense right here, and just, see where it takes you from there.
Of course, Coach Grant out of timeouts. So Mariners got to play to the end now.
Yeah, and that's going to be real tricky here because, like I said earlier, Mariners only has three fouls. And so if Puno gets the ball back with the lead, Mariners going to have to foul four times to put Puno on the line. And that's going to take up some
valuable time. That's going to
run some clock. Yeah.
Dan Barra for Marinol. Dan Barra, Gilmore, Burnett, Harris, and Schramm in for Marinol, and they lose the ball. Panavainoa hustling on D. There he is. It'll be Pinho ball.
And right there, that's a 16th turnover by Marinol this game. And right now, that could have come at a more costly time. Just a little miscommunication there between Schramm and Dan Barra. And, now it's a very fortunate thing for Puno. We'll see what they can do with 39.1 seconds left in the game.
See Coach Grant subbing out his bigs. Puno putting in people can draw some fouls. There's Ogata picking up his first foul, and that's only the Spartans' fourth team foul. Which we'll see this three more times. He'll probably run down to close to 30 seconds or a little under by the time Puno will end up shooting the bonus on this.
And so now, if you're Puno, you got to really think about it. Who are you going to get the ball to? You got to get to your best free throw shooters. Tano Voss is good. Velasquez can shoot, and so can Dason or Watanabe. So, right there, it's going to come down to shooting free throws.
See Dan Barr picking up his second foul. 15 foul for the Spartans. 36.3 seconds remaining. Inbound to Velasquez. That was quick.
Yeah.
They're going to call the foul on Ogata, his second. He's in there to chase Nick Velasquez and drop some fouls. That's about it at this point.
Hey, you get your name in the box score, you participated.
That took 1.3 seconds. Dangerous inbound pass from Pono Fay. I think they're going to call that foul on Burnett. And our math may have been wrong, Mr. Ching, or at least my math must have been wrong. That's the seventh team foul. Velasquez at the line with 33.5 seconds remaining. Nick Velasquez needs to hit at least one of these.
Yes.
At least one of these to make it a two-possession game. So the best Mariners can do would be to tie when they came back. And big free throw for Nick Velasquez.
That's what your seniors do. Your seniors got to come out and play, and you want your senior on the line with the game on the line. And that's just showing the ice water in his veins right now.
Velasquez needing to drain this to make it a two-possession game for the Buff and Blue. Up by three. Velasquez drains it. Four-point lead for the Buff and Blue. Marinol, no timeouts. 33.5 seconds remaining.
This is where Marinol needs to take it strong to the hole.
Looking for Gilmore for a long three. No good. Front iron. Rebound by Pono Fay. Harris was going over the back. He's trying to talk to Donovan Lewis. No good. It'll be Pinho ball. Puno with a four-point lead, 24.8 seconds remaining, and possession.
Right there, Marinol needs to understand there's it's a two-possession game. You could go to the hole strong, get a two-point play, and then foul. But that's what happens when you burn your timeouts in the first half with those 30 seconds.
And you see Velasquez fouled by Gilmore. It'll only be Gilmore's second. 18th foul for the Spartans. See, we're going to check Schramm and Harris back into the game for Marinol. Coach Grant really wants the rebound on the front end of this 1-1. Praying that Nick Velasquez misses the front end.
Yeah, and then Coach Masuda is doing the same thing, summing out Watanabe and Kavainoa, because Kavainoa is going to blanket Gilmore the whole length of the court and make him work.
Velasquez, no good. 4-point lead for the Buff and Blue. Burnett bringing the ball up the floor, 4 points down, and he loses his handle. off of Velasquez. It'll still be Spartan ball with 15.9 seconds remaining. 4-point lead for the Buff and Blue. Spartans need a basket quickly. Trying to run Gilmore through some, oh, quick alley-oop pass. Where was the Punahou defense on that? Tanuvasa with the rebound. How did they get that alley-oop, that near alley-oop pass in, Alan?
That was a nice, it was a nice play set up by the Spartans. They ran a high cross pick at the free throw line, and there was a mix-up between Velasquez and Noah. They both went for Gilmore on the wing. They left Burnett wide open and coming down the middle. It was a great design play, but Burnett just barely missed it.
So Buff and Blue up by four, 11.7 seconds remaining in the game. Makes both of these. This may seal the game for the Buff and Blue. He drains it. It's a 5-point lead for the Buff and Blue.
One more. This is going to take two threes. This is a big shot. If he makes it, Marino has to look for the immediate three.
It's a two-possession game. He drains this. It's a 6-point game. Marino out of timeouts.
This is it.
Token pressure being applied by Tanuvasa and Velasquez. Dan Barra, long three. Back iron, no good. Rebound by Harris. He gets it up, no good. Loose ball, Kanavainoa with the rebound. He's fouled by Burnett. And that's the ball game. The officials are calling it. And that's the final. Buff and Blue, 47. Marion Knoll, Spartans, 41. A much needed victory for the Buff and Blue, Alan.
It's a great victory for the Buff and Blue. It puts them into a tie for first place on the ILH. And the crowd is just going nuts.
Crowd is feeling it because, what I understand, Marion Knoll has a distinct home court advantage. When you're on their court, you know it.
It's going to be great to see them play on a neutral court and see another great game. I mean, these guys, both sides of the team, did a great job.
We need to decide on who we're going to pick for our player of the game.
I think we got to go with the senior, Nick Velasquez.
We'll go with Nick. You want to grab Nick? I will hang on to the... We'll keep things moving up here. With the victory, Punahou ups its record to 15-2 on the year, 6-1 in the ILH. Marion Knoll drops to 18-2, 7-1 in conference. And of course, both teams have three games remaining in the season. And we're sitting down. Right. All right, Nick, can you hear?
Yeah.
Hey, all right. So, those were some clutch free throws you hit at the end, buddy.
I know. I was missing all that, and I just wanted to try and make it up to my team. Hopefully just seal the game.
How was this game different relative to the first one, obviously, from the obvious that you won this one?
Well, yeah, we battled on the boards. We had our center back, Cupano, this game, so he really helped us out underneath. And I just know it's just a mixture of good team effort together. We worked together today, and we didn't get down when we was down, and we just came out the win.
Was there anything specific Coach Darren was telling you coming into this game?
Just keep him off the boards. Got to watch Caleb. He's a great player. Marino's a great team. They really like to get out in the open court and transition, and we just wanted to limit that.
Well, and if it holds the form, there's a distinct possibility you could see them again in the state tournament.
Yeah, hopefully. I feel like it'll be a great rematch.
It would be a great game. Nick Velasquez, thank you very much for talking to us. Congratulations on a great game and a great victory. And with that, we're about 15 minutes away from our nightcap of this Punahou basketball triple header between the Buff and Blue girls and the Iolani Red Raiders. But coming up, just a reminder, this is the end of our winter sports schedule here for Punavision, but next weekend we got Carnival.
Carnival's going to be big. It's always an event that everyone looks forward to.
Punavision's going to be there, televising from the night, doing shows from there. They're going to have a big video screen on the back of the science building.
It's a great event. You know, they do live interviews, live events, talking with different people. It's a wonderful thing that they do down at Carnival. It's just great.
So if you don't have a chance to watch us live, check it out at punahou.edu/webcast. And if you want to see this game again, go to youtube.com/punavision. And this game will be archived in a little bit. We want to say a quick thank you to some of our camera people, Allison Radigan, Matt Shimura, and Meredith Gallant, a junior, sophomore, and freshman collectively, part of Mr. Beersock's top-notch video production crew.
Hey, they did a great job, you know, just getting these games broadcast over the internet, all, you know, and on YouTube is just great for all our alumni across, you know, across the country and across the world.
Right. And with that, we will call it an evening. Alan Ching, thank you very much for joining me today.
Thank you, Mike.
From Hemeter Fieldhouse, I am Mike Machado. Stick around for Yolani Girls and the Buff and Blue Girls. Just a few short moments. Aloha.
Aloha.